Dear students, I shall discuss the solution of algebraic transcendental equations using numerical methods for the equations which contain the terms of the form higher degree polynomials, trigonometric functions, exponential terms, logarithmic terms, and a product of trigonometric and polynomial terms and all that. Generally, what we think of solution of equations. For example, if you have a quadratic equation, in that quadratic equation we define in the standard form as f of x is equal to ax square plus bx plus c. That is, f of x equal to ax square plus bx plus of c. When we want to find out the roots of this equation, first step, what we do? We equate this equation to 0. Then we consider the algebraic methods to find the roots of the equation using x1 and x2. Those values, x equal to minus b plus minus, it is root of b square minus 4ac, it is divided by 2a. Thereby, there are two values we have, x is equal to x1 equal to minus b plus root of, it is b square minus 4ac and divided by it is 2a, and x is equal to x2, that is equal to minus b and then minus of root of, it is b square minus 4ac, it is divided by 2a. Like this we have two values of x, we call them as there are two roots for this quadratic equation. One is x equal to x1 and the another one is x equal to x2. So that two values of this x we are going to calculate, and then we will see that the algebraic method holds good for this. Even when you have third degree equation, to some extent that is by trial and verification method, we can find the roots of this equation so that you will be getting three values of x like x1, x2 and then x3. But in this quadratic equation, we have two values, that is x1 and x2. Therefore, we call these two roots numerically as the roots of the equation for this quadratic equation. When we have a third degree equation, fourth degree equation, fifth degree equation, and other than these polynomial terms, whenever the equation consists of trigonometric function such as sine x, cos x, that is hyperbolic function sine hyperbolic x, cos of hyperbolic x, then exponential term, logarithmic terms and so on, even higher degree polynomials also. So we do not have the ready formula in order to find out the roots of these equations, so that we go for numerical methods, that is algebraic transcendental equations using numerical methods. Any equation contains these types of terms, we call it as transcendental equation. But these terms are called transcendental functions, that means transcendental terms. So that we do not have the algebraic procedure like this to find the roots of the equation, then we go for numerical techniques. As per your syllabus, there are two methods they have mentioned. These two methods they have selected as from two groups of types of methods. First group of types of methods are called bracketing methods, and the next type of group of methods are called as non-bracketing methods. In the case of bracketing methods, we will have regular Falsi method, and in non-bracketing methods, we have Newton-Raphson method. Then, so the introduction goes like this. Whenever we have the equation which contains other than the simple terms like a trigonometric function, hyperbolic function, exponential term, logarithmic function, then we do not have the ready formulas to find out the roots of the equation, then we need to calculate the roots of such equations using approximate methods. We call it as numerical methods, and then those numerical methods we apply step by step. That means the desired degree of accuracy is going to be achieved by those
are two types of formulas. One is contributed by Regula-Falsi method, and the another one is that is Newton-Raphson method. But the first one, Regula-Falsi method, otherwise it is called as false position method. It is called as bracketing method, and another one is non-bracketing method. The introduction goes like this. Let me write one sentence on this introduction. When we have f of x as an equation with quadratic comma biquadratic nature, then the algebraic methods are available to find the roots of the equation f of x equal to 0. If the function or the equation f of x contains the terms of the type sin x, cos x, sin hyperbolic x, cos hyperbolic x, exponential term, then log x, etc., then algebraic methods are not available, then we use numerical methods as follows. So two numerical methods as per your syllabus. There are several numerical methods to solve such equations, but two numerical methods, we will use them. Then the equation f of x contains e to the power x, log x, sin x, and so on, is called transcendental equation. The terms are called, transcendental functions. Then how to solve these transcendental functions using numerical methods? If not the exact value you are going to calculate, but up to the true value, that means nearest to the true value, we calculate by using Newton-Raphson method and Regula-Falsi method. Those numerical methods are two methods as per the syllabus. One is Regula-Falsi method, comes in bracketing method, and the another one is Newton-Raphson method. The first one, bracketing method, this is nothing but Regula-Falsi method.
regular pulsing method.
Otherwise, this is also called as false position method. False position method.
Regular falsi method or false position method. Bracketing method means that is the interval you must have A comma B on the x-axis so that A is the upper limit and B is the lower limit.
So within that range, the graph of the function that is y equal to f of x must fall
so as to get the solution of such equation. And second one, this is called bracketing method, and second one is called non-bracketing method. In this non-bracketing method, important method is Newton-Raphson method. Newton-Raphson method, this needs in the non-bracketing method with the initial value. Initial value means x naught we take, but here that is a comma b. You can also represent this a comma b, for example, x naught up to xn. X naught is the lower limit that is equal to a, and xn is the upper limit that is equal to b,
within which the graph lies. Otherwise, the graph of the function must cross the x-axis so that the end points of the graph must lie in the opposite quadrants, so as to give the product of those functional values must be less than 0.
Now, let us discuss one by one what is the meaning of this regular falsi method
and how this method is going to be applied in the problems and what are the situations that we are going to handle using regular falsi method equation. Of course, the derivations are not there in your syllabus, but I shall write only the equation and then I shall explain in one or two steps how you can also understand the derivation of that particular equation.
Let me discuss the first one, that is regular falsi method. Or it is called false position method, regular falsi method, or it is called false position method. Here, let y is equal to f of x be the given function defined in the interval a comma b such that the graph crosses the x axis.
The graph crosses the x axis
so that the end points, lie in opposite quadrants, so that the end points lie in opposite quadrants, then f of a into f of b less than 0, then the root lies in a comma b. That implies join the end points of the graph by a chord Chord means a straight line.
Chord is a straight line.
And drop perpendicular on x-axis. Then again join the end points. And draw perpendicular on the x-axis. Again, this procedure will be continued.
So, like this, when you write,
the graph will be like this. This is regular Fawlsy method graph, like this. This is the graph for y equal to f of x.
This is the graph of the equation.
This is y axis or equal to f of x, and this is x axis, and then this is origin, and then this is a interval, this one a comma b, and this is b. Okay, this is capital B and this is capital A, but the height is, this is f of a, and the height is, this one is f of b. Therefore, a takes the values a comma f of a, and b takes the values, it is b comma f of b. Then we join these two points of the graph by means of a straight line. Then we draw perpendicular here. Again we join these end points, and then we draw perpendicular, so that these are the point of intersections. Then this must be x naught, this must be x1, x2, like that.
So the intersected part, the intersected location, intersected point on the x-axis will be called as the root. But what is the governing equation for this regular Fawlsy method is that
the governing equation is line joining between two sets of points by the geometry you can derive, that is x minus x1, that is y minus y1, divided by y1 minus y2 equal to x minus x1 divided by x1 minus x2. Then actually to calculate this y equal to fx, but on the x-axis the value of y equal to 0, then y equal to 0 here you substitute, and this a comma f of a will be, that is a of x1 y1, and b, this one will be b of x2 comma y2. These are the two sets of points. So according to this basic geometrical equation, you can substitute x1 y1 as a comma f of a, and x2 y2 as b comma f of b. When you have these two sets of values, then you can separate the value of x, you can do the simplification because derivation is not there. Then you will be getting x equal to a into f of a minus of, sorry, a into f of b, a into f of b minus b into f of a divided by f of b minus f of a. This is the equation after simplification. By substituting these two values, you are getting this one. This we call it as the first approximation. Otherwise, first value of x, we call it as first approximation. The line passing through two given points. Given points means a comma b as x1 y1 and b comma f of a as x2 y2, such that the simplification after substituting x1 equal to a and x2 equal to b and y1 is equal to f of a and y2 is equal to f of b, so that when we have the equation of the straight line passing through two given points, such that x gives the value as x1, that is called first approximation. Then with the help of this first approximation, but here this is positive quadrant, both are plus plus, and this is negative quadrant. So the end points of the graph which I have written, end points of the graph must lie in the opposite quadrants. When we have these values, that means end points in the opposite quadrants, so that the product f of a into f of b must be less than 0. Then after finding this x1, the first approximation in the interval, that is first approximation is a comma b, where x1 lies, whether x1 a comma x1 the graph crosses or x1 comma b the graph crosses, we have to check. Those clarifications I shall do in the problem itself, because the complete derivation is not there in the syllabus. But I shall give the details how this product condition is to be verified in the interval which is to be considered and which interval is to be ignored. So those things I shall explain in the example directly I am taking in, that is regular falsi method. Now I will write one problem on this. Problem on regular falsi method. Find the real root of the equation. Find the real root of the equation x cube minus of 2x minus 5 equal to 0. Using regular falsi method, up to four approximations. Okay. We must have the equation and we must have the number of approximations generally. But compulsory is the equation and the interval may be given or may not be given. And the number of approximations, when it is not mentioned in the problem, like here it is mentioned already, that is four approximations. If it is not mentioned, in the case of regular falsi method, minimum of 3 or 4 approximations you can write, so that you can get the expected type of accuracy in the final answer of the calculation. Okay. Then, how this regular falsi method is going to play the role in giving the first approximation, second approximation, third approximation and fourth approximation. Okay. So, given here, that is f of x equal to x cube minus 2x minus 5. Okay. Now the interval is also not given. But what type of interval you are going to calculate? The condition must be satisfied. What is that condition? Product of f of a into f of b must be less than 0. Must be less than 0 means the product must be less than 0 is f of a into f of b, that is one is a, that is the line takes the first interval as a comma b. The first interval means this is the interval. What is the value of a? Whether f of a is giving positive or negative, the f of b depends on that previous value. If it gives positive, then expect negative value from that. If it gives negative, then expect positive value from that. Then you can get the product of those two functional values will be always less than 0. Therefore, let f of 0, here minus sign is that, let f of 0 is equal to minus 5 less than 0 and f of 1 is equal to, that is 1 minus 2 minus 5, this is equal to minus 6 less than 0 and f of 2 is equal to 8 minus 4 minus 5, this is 9, minus 1 less than or equal to 6, less than 0 and f of 3 is equal to 27 minus 6 minus 5, this is 11, that is 16 then greater than 0.
Here you have to stop, because this gives the negative value and this gives us positive value.
So this is giving the idea that the rule lies in 2, 3, because the functional value, that is f of a into f of b, must be less than 0, because this is negative and this is positive. Therefore, for the negative into positive, that gives us negative. Therefore, the required condition is to be satisfied. F of a into f of b must be less than 0. Then you can get the product less than 0. Therefore, f of a is nothing but a equal to 2 and b is equal to 3. This gives us positive, that is plus sign, and this gives us negative. Therefore, the graph crosses within 2 and 3. So after writing this one, then you can write the first approximation as x1. By regular Fawlsi method, I can write it as RF method. The first approximation, is given by, that is x1 equal to a into f of b minus b into f of a divided by f of b minus f of a. All the values are available here. So this is nothing but x1 is equal to, that is first approximation, a is 2 into f of 3 and minus of b is 3 into f of 2 divided by, that is, this is your equation given, divided by f of 3 minus of f of 2. F of 3 minus of f of 2. Therefore, the first approximation will be calculated like this. Already f of 3 and f of 2, you know that the first approximation is f of 2 is equal to, that is, minus 1. Okay. Then 2 into f of 3 is 16. Then minus 3 into, it is minus 1, and divided by f of 3 is 16 minus of, this is f of 2 is minus 1, that is calculated as x1 is equal to, the first approximation you are choosing, 2.0, it is 588. So you must get the first approximation not outside this interval, because your graph must cross within this interval, that means 2, 3. Therefore, the first approximation x1 is given by, that is, 2.0588. Therefore, this is the first approximation. So 2.0 means near to this here, somewhere you can write here, it is 2.0588. This is called x1. Now you have to check this. Let f of this x1, because this is negative and this is positive, and now its functional value gives whether negative or positive. This is f of x1 is equal to f of, should be 2.0588. So this value gives minus of, it is 0.39, it is 0.8. Then when it is minus sign, this clearly implies here minus is there, here minus, product gives us plus sign, the condition is not going to be satisfied. What is the condition? That is f of that is a into f of b should be less than 0. So this part we ignore and this part we have to consider, implies. So root lies, because f of 2 implies f of 2 into f of 2 point, it is 0.588, is not equal to less than 0. But therefore root lies in x1 comma b, because b is positive and this is negative. Therefore this is the root. Similarly, Now you have to write it as x2 is equal to a, and these values are nothing but 2.0588 and it is 3. This is x, x1 and then b. Therefore, x2 takes, in place of a you have to write it as x1, that is x1 into f of b minus of b into f of x1 and whole divided by f of b minus f of x1. Therefore, this gives x1 is 2.0588 and f of 3 minus 3 into f of 2.0588 whole divided by f of 3 minus f of 2.0588. Then x2 takes the value approximation 0.813. Then this also gives f of x2, you have to verify whether positive or negative. This also gives less than 0. You verify this. This also gives us less than 0 means x2, that value is 2.0813. So this is also giving negative sign. Therefore, this part we are going to ignore. Then root lies in which interval? That is x2, b. Root lies in x2, b. That implies root lies in x2, b. So the important thing is, after every calculation you have to find out the functional value, whether that functional value gives positive or negative, and depending on that other end value, other end means this value, you have to verify the product should be always less than 0. If it is not less than 0, then you have to ignore that part and you have to consider the previous part. But in this problem, previous part we are ignoring and the next part we are going to consider. Root lies in x2, b, that is nothing but 2.0813 and then 3. This is equal to, it is x2, b. X2 means a, that is comma b. Then the third approximation you can get, totally 4 values you have to write. In the same fashion, if you write third approximation, that is a into f of b minus b into f of a divided by f b minus f a. This is equal to, in place of a, x2, that is f b minus b into f of x2, and this is divided by fb minus, it is f of x2. This value takes for third approximation, that is 2.08, it is 62. Then this also gives negative when you calculate the functional value. When it is giving negative, this also gives functional value as negative, f of x3, that is f of, it is 2.0862, is also less than 0. This clearly implies root lies in, that is x3, b. This is equal to a, b. Then fourth approximation, x4 is equal to, that is x3 into f b minus b into f of x3 and whole divided by f of b minus f of, it is x3. Then it is equal to, you can write the value, then x4 comes to be 2.0915. Therefore, every time a small interval will be ignored, and then next part of the interval we are going to consider depending on this product verification. Every time product verification is important, and you must get your calculation, because you can't get as you wish. That means you must get your calculation only within these two numbers, that is 2 and 3, not outside this range in this method, that is in regular falsi
method.
Then like this, this is the x4, it is the required value. So x4 is equal to 2.0915. this is the fourth approximation.
Up to fourth approximation in the statement of the problem it is asked, then we have calculated up to fourth approximation.
Okay, I shall take one more example on this regular Fauci method, then how these steps can be carried out. Here there is no different procedure, the same procedure will be followed. If the interval is given to you, it is an advantage, but if the interval is not given, then you need to identify the interval, and then with that interval you have to substitute one
after the other number in the interval, and then you have to work out.
Okay, I will write one more example here how this regular Fauci method is going to be applied. Example number 2, find the real root of the equation, real root of the equation x into e to the power x is equal to cos x using regular Fauci method. Using regular Fauci method, here also it is asked to write up to x4. Take four approximations. It is given. Take four approximations in the solution. Okay, and here also it is not given.
The interval is not given. Then you need to calculate the interval. If the interval is given, you write as it is. But by once you have to verify that interval, and then you see that if those numbers are going to be satisfied, then you can enter that.
Okay, what is the equation given for us? That is given that x into e to the power of x is equal to cos x. So that this can be taken as cos x into, otherwise cos x minus x into e to the power of x is equal to 0. This is f of x is equal to cos x minus x into e to the power x, that is equal to 0. Cos x minus x into e to the power of x equal to 0. Anyway, with this, what is the functional value? Let us calculate. That is f of 0, this is cos 0 is 1, minus of this is 0, this is equal to 1 greater than 0, and f of 1, that is cos 1. You have to operate this by taking the mode in your calculator as radian, because 1 you are feeding, it is not a degree, to the trigonometric function. Here it is given as cos x. Therefore, f of 1 is equal to, you are getting 2.17798. Then this clearly implies this is minus 1, it is less than 0, and this is greater than 0. Implies root lies in, that is 0, 1. So root lies, it is 0, 1 means we take this as a, b, and your representation of the line, that is 0, then 1, 0, 1, and this is a, and this is b, and b is positive, this is positive, and this is negative, a is negative. Then by regular Fauci method, by RF method, we have the first approximation, we have the first approximation as x1 is equal to a into f of b minus b into f of a divided by f of b minus f of a. This is equal to a value is 0 and f of 1 minus 1 into f of 0 divided by f of 1 minus it is f of 0.
So that this calculation comes to be x1 equal to that is 0.31467.
Then you need to calculate or verify what is this value in the product, that is f of a into f of b less than 0. You have to check it. Then f of x1 that is equal to f of, then you need to write f of x1 is equal to f of this one means 0.31467 in the equation, this equation. Okay, so this also gives negative, this also gives negative is this part you have to ignore, and then you will be getting x2 the next approximation. So this clearly indicates root lies when it is x1, this is negative, root lies in, root lies in, that is x1 comma b. Then x2 is equal to, in place of a you are going to write as x1, then f of b minus it is b into it is f of x1 and whole divided by f of b minus it is f of a. So this is equal to x1, this is the number that is 31467, and f of 1 that is b minus of b1 into then f of 0.31467, then this divided by f of 1 and minus of f of 0.31467. So this value comes to be, that is x2, 0.44673. So this is the second approximation. So first approximation is 0.31467 and second approximation is 0.44673. Then in the similar fashion you must write other two values, thereby you can get x3, verify that. I am just giving the answer 0.49402, and x4 the next approximation you are getting 0.50995. You verify up to this fourth approximation you are going to calculate. Then I should write some extra problems on this regular Fallacy method. You can try, and I shall explain the next method. I'll write a general question that is for using the regular Fallacy method. Apply RF method. Apply RF method to find, in general I am giving, to find up to third approximation from the following equations. That is, first example, x cube, x cube minus 3x and plus 4 equal to 0. Second one, here also the interval is not given. Then x into e to the power of x minus 3 is equal to 0. For example, here the interval which I calculated, I will give that interval. This is minus 2 comma minus 3. Then for this also interval is not given, let me give 1 comma 2. You can take the same thing, that is a comma b here, and this is also a comma b, And similarly, the next problem, that is third one, x to the power 3 minus 9x plus 1 equal to 0.
So these 2-3 problems you can try, and I shall explain the next method, that is Newton-Raphson method. In the Newton-Raphson method, the next one is non-bracketing method. There we do not expect the product piece to be satisfied, that is f of a into f of b less than 0. So without satisfying the condition, we will start with the initial value. But whenever this type of interval is not given, even initial condition is also not given, then in that case, we consider the value as initial approximation. By this method, we will find the f of a, f of 0, 1, 2, 3, like that. Then first number also you can take, or middle number also you can take, or last number also you can take. Like that you can take, and then you can go for the selection of x naught, and then you can write. So what is Newton-Raphson method? Let me explain.
Newton-Raphson method. This is called non-bracketing method. Non-bracketing method means we do not expect the bracket every time where the function is going to satisfy. Then, same time, let y is equal to f of x defines in a comma b for f of x equal to 0, the root is to be obtained, using the initial value, that is x naught. So when we have this initial value as x naught, then what we have to do is, in this, the correction factor is to be calculated, and then initial value will be added. Okay. Then x1 is equal to x naught plus delta x. This is equal to x naught plus h. So in the interpolation chapter already you have studied x naught, x1 and x2, x3 and so on. This is the spacing. This is the spacing where h is equal to delta x. H is equal to delta x is called the increment or the displacement between two successive values. The displacement between two successive values of x, we are taking it as the spacing between two values of x, and then we will write it as, that is delta x. Okay. And then what we have to write is delta x, which is to be added as a correction factor, so that the original number will be calculated as x1 plus x1 is equal to x0 plus delta x correction factor. Then this correction factor will be calculated using Taylor series. Then in that, ignoring the second degree terms, and we will consider only the first order derivative in the Taylor series for theorem for one variable, and then we will be able to get this delta x value. X1 is equal to x0 minus, it is f of x0 divided by, it is f dash of x0. This is called first approximation by Newton-Raphson method. Next, the second approximation will be x1, that means one unit should be the difference in between these two values, x1 minus f of x1, and divided by, it is f dash of x1. Therefore, second approximation will be in terms of first approximation. Then third approximation will be x3 is equal to x2 minus of f of x2, and divided by, it is f dash of x2. This is third approximation. In general, like this, if you go on calculating, then xn plus 1 is equal to xn minus f of xn divided by, it is f dash of, it is xn. So f dash of xn, you are going to calculate, that is on the right side second term,
that is contributed by Taylor series, and it is nothing but correction factor.
So thereby this is called general approximation up to n plus 1, but it goes like second in terms of first, third in terms of second, fourth in terms of third.
This type of procedure is called the iteration process. In this iteration process, how the calculations are going to be taken by choosing the individual value, that is initial value, and then number of approximations can be calculated, that we will see in the problem. Let me write
the first problem. According to regular Newton-Raphson method,
the first problem on Newton-Raphson method is like this.
Example, find by Newton-Raphson method the root of the equation x into e to the power x minus 2 is equal to
0. X into e to the power of x minus 2 is equal to 0
up to two approximations.
After two approximations, here as a simple case, the first problem I am taking up to two approximations. Then how this Newton-Raphson method is going to be applied step by step, that is to be identified the first initial value, and that is to be inserted in the first approximation. After calculating x1, then x2 will take in terms of x1.
That is what we are going to do in Newton-Raphson method. Okay, so what is the equation given and what is required according to Newton-Raphson method, the general case? What is that general case in the Newton-Raphson method? That general case will be the function and its derivative. Both are required in this case. Okay. In the solution, given equation is f of x is equal to x into e to the power of x minus 2. Here, the initial value is not given, but initial value will be calculated by the bracketing method itself. Interval you are going to fix, but we don't claim that the approximation forthcoming approximation should lie in certain interval. That interval concept is not there in the Newton-Raphson method.
Let us substitute f of 0 is equal to 0 minus 2 less than 0, and f of 1 is equal to 1 into e to the power 1 minus 2. E to the power 1 means e value is 2.70. So 2.70 minus of 2, that is equal to 0.70 something, but it is greater than 0. Here itself we are getting root lies in, that is 0 comma 1. Root lies in 0 comma 1. But we will take in this case the value, that is x naught is equal to any number in between this one. But in whichever the interval you are getting as 0 in the Newton-Raphson method, normally non-zero number we select to go for the initial value. To go for the initial value, the non-zero number we are going to take, because whenever in some terms
of the given problem,
if all are containing x as coefficient, then if you substitute 0, then you will be getting it as
0 only. So to avoid that, we consider that is non-zero number. Even you can take 1 also. Let x naught is equal to 1. This is our initial value. Let x naught is equal to 1 means, by Newton-Raphson method, xn plus 1 is equal to xn minus of xn, f of xn divided by, it is f dash of xn. Then, the first approximation is x1 is equal to x0 minus f of x0 divided by f dash of x0. So, this is f of x, and then f dash of x, you have to write the differentiation of this, that is equal to, this is a product rule, e to the power x, x differentiation is 1, first into differential of second plus second into differential of first, that is e to the power of x, and plus x into e to the power x. Therefore, x naught, and this is f of x naught means f of x naught is x naught and e to the power x naught minus 2 divided by e to the power x naught, then that is plus of x naught into e to the power, it is x naught. So after the differentiation is over, then x1 at x0 is equal to, that is 1, you have to substitute 1 minus, it is 1 into e to the power 1 minus 2, that is e to the power 1 minus 1 into e to the power 1. So the first approximation gives the calculation, that is 0.86, it is 79. This is the value of x1, 0.86, it is 79. So this is the first approximation we have according to Newton-Raphson method. What we did in regular Falsi method, we were verifying after every approximation in the interval what it gives, whether negative value or positive value product gives, but here it is not necessary. And in a similar fashion, the next number we are going to calculate, that is for second approximation. So, then x2, let x2 is equal to, according to Newton-Raphson method, x1 minus f of x1 divided by f dash of x1. X1 is already taken 0 point, that is 8679 minus of f of 0.8679 and divided by f dash of 0.8679. So, according to this, you must substitute, according to this, that is equal to 0.8679 minus, in this case, this is the term, that is x1, you have to write here, that is 0.8679 into e to the power 0.8679 minus 2 divided by e to the power 0.8679 and minus 0.8679, and that is e to the power, this quantity into e to the power 0.8679. So when you have this, this is for x2, means second approximation, that is given as calculated as 0.853. So this is what the value that you have to check it. If there is any correction, then you can make that correction if any mistake is there in the calculation. That means, this is the procedure I am explaining. Whatever the previously calculated value, that is called x1, to be inserted in, that is x2. Thereby, you will be calculating the next approximation using the previous approximation. The remaining problems I shall continue in the next lecture.